You've probably received a flurry of emails from your IT team this week, and maybe you've even seen them running around the office in a tizzy. Some systems have been taken offline, and everyone's talking about this thing called Log4j. What's happening? Should you be worried? Let's dive in and find out. Log4j is the name of an open source library that developers who program using the Java programming language use to help figure out what's going on with their applications. The name refers to logging for Java. Logging is the simple act of writing out various events to a file somewhere. This happened, this didn't, that type of thing. And when you write these types of messages, you want to make sure that they include the time the event happened, what part of the system was in use, and a bunch of other contextual information. Log4j makes that easier for developers. That's why it's used in a lot of programs that are written in the Java programming language. Now, there's no reason you would have ever heard of Log4j. It's one of the many projects that run quietly in the background, helping developers build all sorts of things that you do use directly. The fact that Log4j is not front and center is the biggest part of the issue that IT teams are currently dealing with. Think of it this way. Log4j is like a driving test instructor. They're sitting in the car, quietly writing down everything that you, the driver, are doing. Turned left nicely, went a little too fast down this street, had to try 3 different times before successfully parallel parking, that type of thing. Now, scale that back a little bit and think of all the cars on the road right now. How many of them have driving test instructors in them? How would you even begin to figure that out? You may have to stop each one and check, or maybe you could position someone on the side of the road and look into the cars as they passed by. It's a hard problem to solve. Now, most of the time when issues like this occur, we're just trying to figure out how many cars are blue. Now, right now, we're trying to figure out if something specific is inside of each car. Now, most teams keep an inventory of what's running in their environment, but Log4j is such a low-level library that it's not normally tracked. So why does any of this matter? Well, on the 9th of December, the team of volunteers that write and maintain Log4j announced that there was a serious security issue. Attackers could easily use one of the features of the library to run their code on your systems. That's bad. Real bad. In fact, this issue is rated a 10 out of 10 for severity. Now, thinking back to our driving test instructors, imagine the chaos if someone could simply play a song over the radio that made them all grab the wheel and take over the cars they were in. Not good. But there is a little good news, and that is that the fix is actually quite simple to apply. One small configuration change can turn off the affected feature, and an update to Log4j or the applications that use it can remove the feature altogether. The problem is knowing what you have to fix. We're back to the driving test instructor again. How many cars on the road have one inside right now? This is what teams are running around trying to figure out. How big is their organization's exposure to this issue? Just how big is the list of systems that they need to go and fix? Security vulnerabilities like this are simply mistakes, and mistakes happen. The tech that we use every day is quite complicated under the covers. Log4j has written billions and billions of events over its lifespan and has rarely ever had any big issues. No one likes dealing with these situations, and the timing of this one is particularly frustrating with the holidays and year-end upon us. The key to successfully navigating this? Don't panic. Work through these basic steps. Find out where Log4j is in your environment. Apply the configuration, change, or recommended fix from the system vendor, and then continue to monitor the announcements from the Log4j project and your IT vendors to make sure you have the latest info. This requires a lot of grunt work to fix, and no one likes having to pull longer hours to get that done. But we've seen cyber criminals actively trying to take advantage of this issue in a number of different ways. If you're interested, there are more technical details in the comments below. For now, just remember that the race is on between your IT teams trying to fix this issue in your environment and cyber criminals wanting to profit from your resources and data. So if you see your IT team frazzled and looking burnt out, make sure you take a minute to say thank you, and please be understanding if your other requests take a little bit longer.